So I'm going to tell you about what a psychic dual scan is with Akvile, but more, I'm going to tell you about Akvile and her psychic abilities. All right, so a psychic dual scan, if you don't know, is when a person gets on Zoom session with us, and together Akvile and I help that person look into their stuff. Akvile can see their entity issues, their abduction issues, psychic phenomena, ET interference, all kinds of things. Secret space program stuff, targeted individual, why, how, when, all this stuff. And also she can look into past life stuff, your past lives, and she sees it real clearly. And then we figure out what's going on with you. We answer your questions, and then we start getting to work together, the three of us, to detach from the entities or understand what happened and the agreements made to make the connection, being targeted, all this stuff to help you resolve your issues and make the world a better place and help you feel better and get more control in your life. All right. With that said, I'm going to share with you what kind of psychic Akvile is. She's an incredibly natural psychic, no practice, no learning, no, you know, like, how can I learn how? No. Ever since she was a little kid, she could see entities. She could see them out the window floating around, you know, dead people and stuff. And she learned at an early age to not stop asking her parents about who they were and why are they out there floating around my window, that sort of thing. So when I met Akvile, she was 15 years old, and she had been watching my YouTube channel, and she was already very eager to learn about the world and what was going on behind the scenes. Now, learning about the cabal and the shadow governments and the reptilians and the ETs and all this stuff. Even back then, I was talking about this sort of thing. So, this was over 10 years ago. Okay. So, she reached out to me and asked me some questions about getting out of body. And I started teaching her some stuff. And we became friends. And then I started teaching her. We would get together on Uvu. It's like Zoom, but earlier. We'd get online, and I found out how freaking amazing she is. She sees incredibly vividly. This, like, her psychic phenomena ability. It's like if she's watching a movie on TV or, you know, on the computer, she literally can draw herself. She almost can't help herself. She draws in to the movie experience, and it's 3D holographic. It's not a flat screen experience anymore for her. She's inside the movie universe. And I've asked her about this stuff. She can literally, like say there's a person on the sidewalk in the movie, just an extra. She can take that person's point of view and feel their feelings. It's an extra as a movie goes, but as a movie universe, there's a whole thing going on how we all create universes, and we're creating everybody in our own universe, and we co-create this physical universe. So this creational phenomena, she does knowingly and with great perception. So she can be in a movie, take the viewpoint of an extra standing on the street corner, look through that extra's eyes at the movie universe. She won't see a camera behind the hero. She will see the movie universe. This is how amazing she is. And that's just with that one thing. She can be walking down the hall. I've shared this story before. She can be walking down the hall from the living room to the kitchen, and her consciousness can shift without her meaning to, and she will be in an alternate reality. absolutely as real as this one, and she can live there for months. Come back here before she gets to the end of the hall into the kitchen. And she can remember every detail. I go, really? It's like, so the time's different. Like, you can remember all the details? She goes, yeah. Wow. So, she would, I don't know about nowadays what she's doing with the out-of-body stuff, but she used to get out of body almost every night. In other words, kind of like we all do, but do we remember what was going on when the body was asleep? And she does, or did. And she would go to other worlds and help people. This is one of our recurring thing. It was obviously a mission and it's important to her. She would go to worlds that had been attacked by the regressive ETs of that universe, whether it's physical universe or astral or alternate realities. It doesn't really matter, the labels. But she would go to these other realms and worlds where they had been attacked, and she would help the remaining population, the refugees, their cities destroyed. And a lot of times the ETs, the bad ETs, would be landing and doing cleanup to control and dominate the entire planet or realm. And Akvile would be helping the people there. So it's always in her heart and it's her nature to help. Okay. So, easily gets out of body, can see your imagery. Oh, when she looks at a person's past life stuff, she's an empath too, right? So she feels your pain. She has an extremely high level of confront. And she doesn't internally dialogue, probably a little, but hardly at all. She doesn't talk in her head. She's a perceiver, a looker, a smeller, a listener. And this keeps her in present time and gives her an edge, so to speak. So anyway, when she looks into your stuff, she's clear in here. So what she's seeing and feeling is all yours, right? Because she's tuned into you. And now she can look at every detail in your past life phenomena, whether it's secret space program, missions you've been on, or, in Atlantis, Lemuria, another planet, all this sort of thing. And sometimes we'll be dealing with entities, so she can see the entity or entities that are messing with you. And then together, her and I will communicate with the entity. Sometimes we can have you or the client communicate to the entity. It depends on each individual's ability to perceive and sense and communicate with whatever entity phenomena they're dealing with. But oftentimes, Akvile and I will communicate with the entity and we'll deal with it. Sometimes we need to find out what's the problem. And it's got issues. And it would love to break free. And so we're able to ask and snoop and figure out what the entity's problem is. Why is it hanging on to you, sucking your louche, or messing with you, or trying to control you? And sometimes they want to break free, and we can find out if this is the case, and we can help them break free of you and their own controllers. Okay? And then, as needed, we can go after their controllers. Because oftentimes these are lesser entities that are controlled by stronger entities or beings or demons or reptilians or greys or something. Okay, so then we go after those guys. And Akvile can see these reptilians. She can be on their ship in a heartbeat. If you've ever watched Courtney Brown and the Farsight Institute, where these remote viewers doing their thing, Akvile can do that sort of stuff. She can pop into the spacecraft, for example. I remember this one time. She's on a spacecraft with this big reptilian guy. He's big old, you know, what 9 to 12 feet tall or something. And she's talking to him. And she sees it crystal clear. She doesn't just see it. She feels it, sees every detail. I've asked her. I said, well, we can do this thing where I guide her. This is something we used to, I'm going all over the place, but she's absolutely amazing. So we started, about 10 years ago, we started doing this guided thing where I would guide her into her out-of-body experience. So she can just kind of just be there and go where I guide her. And now that she, so I'd guide her onto a spacecraft, right? And now she's talking to the people on the spacecraft. Now, when you do this kind of work, there's your analytical thinking, beta thinking. It's a brainwave frequency sort of thought. And it's, you analyze and plan and strategize. And what am I going to ask next? What do I want to do? Where am I going to go? This is all beta mind stuff. So it can affect one's ability to just shift, you know, into theta or alpha or delta states and just be in these higher realms and exploring. No analyzing, just looking, perceiving, deciding, doing, right? And perceiving. So together, I would guide her on these spaceships. And there was one in particular that we'd go to. It's a big ship. Lots of people, diplomats from other ET races would be there. And I would guide her and she would be, I go, well, what do you see? Well, it's just a big common room and there's a table with food on it and there's all these different ETs walking around. I go, well, what do they look like? Well, they're all kinds. I go, well, pick one. Okay, well, there's a guy over there standing by the table. So I'm guiding her. She's on the other side. She might have her eyes closed, maybe open, because she can do it both ways. And she says, yeah, he's standing there. He's got this, he's got a big blue suit on with the gold lapels, and he's got a gold sort of thing like this. And is he human? No, not exactly. And I said, well, can you go over and talk to him? Yeah. So I'm guiding her. She's having a conversation with this ET, finding out a little bit about his story. And I would say, well, hey, you want to try out the food? Like, this is over 10 years ago, right? And so we're just learning how to do this together. And she says, yeah, yeah. So she's tasting the food on the table, and she can literally taste it and feel it, its texture. She shakes this guy's hand. I have her shake this guy's hand, this weird-looking ET guy. What's his hand feel like? It's kind of leathery. Yeah, oh, really? Yeah, yeah. What's the temperature? Oh, it's kind of cool. I'm going, and, yeah, absolutely amazing. So we learned a lot about the ETs in that way. We met the ship's captain, and they had some real issues, and we helped them with their, you know, issues that they had. You know, they're on missions or they're being attacked or tracked or targeted by the other ETs and their other spacecraft. So we would do all that sort of stuff. So we started working together a lot in this way. And her abilities or her awareness of her abilities and her understanding of what she can do just kept expanding and expanding. So over 10 years later, or about 8 years later or whatever, we decided to do, actually she came up with it. I said, hey, let's make some money. We got to make some money here. And she said, well, okay. I could do these readings. Tell me more. Anyway, it was her idea to do these readings on people. I said, well, we could just invite people and together, because she was kind of shy back then, and she wasn't on YouTube or anything. And I said, well, I could find us some people, and we could do it together, and I'll talk to them and stuff, and then you can just listen and tune in. She says, yeah, we can do that. Yeah, we can do that. So it's basically her idea to do these psychic dual scans way back then. And we started doing them. And we started helping people. And it just kept going and going. So that's kind of how it started. And that's who we are and how we do it and why we do it. I guess a little bit more about why and me is that when I turned 20 years old, I started learning past life regression stuff. I learned a lot about that. I got a lot of past life regressions myself. I started understanding the big picture out in the galaxy sort of thing. And then about 1984, I learned about entities and techniques, how to spot them, how to talk to them, communicate with them, and get them out of your space. Many different kinds of entities, many different reasons for being in our space. So I started learning all that stuff and was able to do that. And then I taught all this stuff to Akvile. And she's a natural and she's a genius. Literally, real high IQ. She learns things so fast. It's like, wow. So I taught her everything I could. And then she got ahead of me now. The little girl is like, what the hell, girl? She's as brilliant as can be. And she's just taken off, right? So through all of that, we're still doing these psychic deep scans for people, all right? So if you'd like our assistance with any of these kind of strange phenomena, incubus, succubus, you know, people are being molested in the sleep, but they're not fully asleep and they know what's going on. They can feel it physically. And I'm going, what the hell? That's hardcore. And they can't get rid of them. Sometimes it's family curses. And somebody in the family has been doing black magic or voodoo or some weird thing. Or maybe, a great auntie or a great grandma or something. Anyway, all that dark stuff can be influencing you when you're just like, what? I didn't. Hey, wasn't me. Why me? So we look into why you. What's the deal? What's the relationship you have in this thing where you're being targeted so much? And then there's the government and the three-letter agencies. A secret space program. It's like, why you? Know yourself, right? That's the thing. And what do you have to do with all of this? We can help you sort all of that out and help you get your feet on the ground and clarity on what's going on with you and what you can do now and what you can do next. Okay. So that's Akvile and me doing the psychic deep scans together. And that's how we got started. Okay. Alrighty. Thanks for watching. If you'd like a session with us, there'll be a link below. And we look forward to working with you. Okay. Alrighty. Take care now, gang. Okay?